Hello everybody and welcome back to Stardew Valley. Where? It's the last day of winter, which means it's the last day we can catch any winter fish. So I'm going to spend today doing quite a bit of fishing and see what we can get. Now, before we do that, I need to put some of these away. I'll see if any of these fish fit in the fridge. Oh, I must have cleaned the fridge out because there is room in it, which there isn't normally. Periwinkle, you can go in there. Snail, yeah. Don't need my cranberries. Don't need half this stuff. Should be tidy for once in our lives. In my life. I'm sure you guys are like totally tidy all the time. Never mess anything up. It's just I am the messy one. Okay. Sell the duck egg minis. Go see the chickens. Read my mail. And then we'll go fishing. And then we're going to have to see what kind of seeds we want for the spring. We're going to have to go see Pierre. I found this in a drawer somewhere. I thought you could use it. Pam. That looks kind of suspicious. Oh, energy tonic. Okay. Not what I was thinking. Right, so let's go see the chickens. Yay, you made me a large egg. Two large eggs. You're such good chickens. I love you so. Love you, and I love you, and I love you, and I love you. Definitely need to expand our cow and chicken selection as year two goes on. But I think we're doing all right to have a full complement of sort of two coops worth of ducks and chickens. Oh, I got some stuff in these. And for once I actually have bait on me to replace it with. We've done all of them. We've done all of them. Okay. In we go. Let's see the other guys. So we've got some duck egg mayonnaise and some more duck eggs. Yay. I lose track of who I've clicked on in this coop because there's so many people here. Well, ducks, I suppose, not really people. Modafan loves me half a heart. Calypso looks sad and doesn't love me. Fedoras looks fine. But doesn't love me either. Right, let's put a couple of eggs. We'll just put some normal eggs in. Normal eggs, in you go. And we'll carry on hoarding all the eggs in this chest until I get around to making more mayonnaise makers. I just emptied this inventory. That was full of stuff. And I missed an egg. Like loads of void eggs. I don't take them down the mines as food. They don't seem to be good for much else. Okay, next. Oh, did I feed them? That would be just like me to run away and not feed them. Yep. Okay, so I'm gonna quickly go check on the cows. Then I'm going to go to, I think, the big lake by the mines. We're just going to spend a bit of time fishing there. Hello. Hello. The main thing here is to feed them. If I had my bucket, which I don't, I would milk them, but I don't have time today. Milk you another day. Right, so done all of that. Just gonna put a few things in a chest. There's my bucket. out of the way. So we have plenty of room for fish. Yeah, I might need my fishing rod for that whole fishing thing. Just put the bait. No, I need the bait. The bait should be in my fishing rod. I don't know. I would like to go to the secret forest as well and get some more wood, but I don't know if I'll have time. The wood will still be there when the season changes. The fishes might not, so we'll see what fish we can catch. Whee! I think we have like fish from all over the place that we need to catch, but I'm just gonna try up here first. So many wiggly worms, I never bring my hoe with me. We may as well pick up all the sort of forage that we won't be able to get for another year. Now I'm just gonna go around here, I think, and we are going to fish. Let's see what we can find. Algae! Yay! That's not what I wanted. Got it! Perch. Okay. I don't think we need that for the community centre. Let's have a quick look. River bundle. Fish tank. Lake bundle. We need a sturgeon. River bundle. We need catfish, tiger trout, and some fish. Okay. That was stupid. I never learn my lesson, do I? Come on! Stop running away. Stop running away, I said. Oh, you're a pest. Come on! I feel that catch was well deserved. A chub. I don't think that's one we need either. God, these guys are hard. Bullhead. What the heck are you? Oh! I don't know what that was. But that was wiggly. Come on. Be mine, fish, be mine, bullhead. I'll keep going for a while longer. I have plenty of energy left. Oh, you're all over the place, fish. You're making me go all over the place. I don't appreciate that. These fish are ones I need for the community center. Mind you, it's all good money, I suppose, if I sell them or make them into sashimi. As always with fishing, up is easier than down. Another chub. As the fish goes higher, it's really quite easy. As the fish goes lower, it's really hard. I really hope that whatever that wiggly fish was, that it wasn't something that we need for the community centre. Because if it is, then that's bad times. No! Come back, little fish. I need to take my own advice about keeping the fish near the top of the meter, as per my fishing tutorial. Which has actually done surprisingly well on my channel, so I'm guessing that there's lots of people who can't fish the same as me. I'm not a good fish person on this game. A fish person? A good fish catcher, I guess. Hey, perfect! Largemouth bass. Nice. I think I already had one of those in the community centre though, but I'll keep that because sometimes you get quests asking for them, so they're actually quite handy. Oh, what are you? What are you? What are you indeed? I can't catch you. Yay, more largemouth basses. I imagine that the one that goes really fast is probably one that I desperately need for the community centre. That's just the way this game will go. I know it. Come on, you. More chubs. I feel I maybe should have done a bit more fishing in my time, in my winter time. Come on. I'm getting good at these largemouth basses, aren't I? Oh. And the wrong way around. Fishing 101, don't stand the wrong way around. Oh, quite a lot of fish, it's good. Oh, that lost my perfect there. A record perch, yay! I don't know if the records give you anything. Or whether they're just to show you what you've caught. Oh, what are you? What are you? I want to know what you are. You are so fast. How am I ever going to catch those super fast ones? Yeah, like fishing level 100. Come on. Stay steady, stay steady, come on, come on, stay steady. Yay! Another largemouth bass. Oh, I'm so good at catching those. I'm gonna have enough for the whole rest of the game now. I'm just keeping them in the chest. quick, that one. I don't know what it is. I wish I did. I wish I was skilled enough to get it. I bet it's really awesome. I promise I won't spend the next day fishing. I'll spend the next day planting. I do think that I've maybe got all of the variety of fish I'm likely to get out of this lake now, except for whatever that really fast one is. Don't know what that is. Someone also said I should bomb the mine, so I'm going to try that soon. Yay, perfect! Got me! Yeah, I'm gonna go back now, I think. We can make all our fish into sashimi. And give it as people... No, give it to people as presents. We have a whole fridge full of sashimi. We can give that to people. And they will love us. And they will think we're great. And I don't know why... Oh, I'm halfway back now anyway. I don't know why I didn't just go into the mine and use the railway. Took me ages to unlock that and I never use it. So I'm going to go back and I'm just going to grab my axe and then we're going to see what fish we can get in that little like pond in the cinder forest. Gotta find my axe first though. Where is my axe? I have lots of chubs and perches. I am a terrible woodsman. A woodsman would never leave his axe lying around in a chest. But I am Shelab, and I am the disorganized one. So I just leave everything in the chests. Okay. Let's go to the secret forest. It's full of mysteries. I must remember to check this traveling cart because I think it sometimes has things that I need for my community center completion. Like we got that puffer fish and stuff. Okay, so first thing we're gonna do is collect all the hardwood and kill any slimes that are threatening to kill us or poison us. Some good forage in this winter area. Oh, do you know, I need something to eat. Oh, good job, I got loads of algae. That'll keep me going for a while. Oh, that didn't do very much for my energy. 13 energy. So 60, 27 out of 60, right, okay. That'll last us a little while. Right, let's go and get these things. These tree stumps that magically grow, even though the trees never grow back, but the tree stumps magically grow back. I think that's kind of weird, don't you? Definitely, I think that's very weird. What kind of tree stumps just grow back as tree stumps? I think that's wizardry, so I think Rasmodius has something to do with this. And in fact, I've got like a whole chest full of those things that Rasmodius absolutely loves. And I'm not giving him a gift like twice a week at the moment, so I need to get on top of that. I really do. Oh, it's like really late now. I'm not gonna have time to go fishing in the pond thing. And I won't have time tomorrow because it'll be like spring. First day of spring is important for watering. I know it's getting late. I need this wood. It's important. Okay. I really want to see what's in this lake. Oh, I don't have time. Oh, that's so annoying. Oh, at least I got the wood before it respawned. I can always fish in there another day. I love how the traveling person like just leaves her pig lying around. So just stay there with the cart while I gallivant off for like half the week, and then I'll come back and I'll sell a few things. And the pig's like, really? When am I getting food? I know everyone else gets to sleep in a nice barn and I just get to stand out in the cold. Kind of feel sorry for the pig, even though he does have cool shades. Right. To bed we go, and we'll wake up and it will be a beautiful spring day, and we shall plant many, many seeds. Oh, level 4 fishing. I have a recycling machine. Ooh. Level 8 forage. Wow, levels ahoy. Level 8 foraging. Plus 1 to my axe proficiency. Plus 1 to wildberry harvesting. And I can now make a warp totem to the farm. Very nice. I'll be able to warp everywhere. 2 duck mayonnaises for 660 gold. Very nice. And we have started, officially, year 2. So, what are we going to do with that then? The first thing we're going to do is stick a load of fish in the fridge. Anything that we think will fit. Which is about just that. Oh, hi! Ooh, I have not seen you before. Hello, my name is Kent. I just got back last night from overseas. My wife told me that a new farmer had moved in while I was gone. Ooh. Well, I just wanted to introduce myself. I'll see you around. Another person that I've got no hearts with. I hope you enjoy the gift I sent you. Well, goodbye. I'll shoot you a little person. How cute. Emily. She gave me a sea urchin. Oh, how sweet. Love you, Emily. Right, so. We're going to need to clear this farm up a little bit. Ugh, I don't know. So much stuff. Some of it stacks, some of it doesn't. Some of it I've got no idea if I need some. Yes. Right. Okay. And a crocus. There we are. Right. So what is in the way of our farms at the moment? I'm going to need my hoe. And then we're going to need to go and see Pierre. There is my hoe. So we will hoe the land. So we are going to need enough to fill 8 times whatever amount of squares we've managed to fill with sprinklers over the winter time. Which is... I knew that was going to happen. Which is actually quite a lot. You know what, I'm going to pick that middle square and then put the sprinkler on because I don't like things to be all uneven. It sucks when things are uneven. I must ensure that I don't spend too long hoeing the fields and miss Pierre. So, how many have you got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times 2, 12, 13, 14, 15 times 8. 10 times 8 is 80, 40, 120 seeds will be needed to fill this whole area just down to where I've done the sprinklers so far. I believe that I may have enough gold just stored away, then I might be able to make one or two more. And then, I'm going to think about my trellis crops, but I won't think about them quite yet. Because, unfortunately, I don't yet have any pine resin to make barrels, so I'm not able to make wines and beers yet. There's a nice bit of wood there. And we have grass back. We did manage to make it through the winter without having to buy any more grass. And I didn't miss too many days of the chickens. So I think that's quite good. We will start making honey again now, which is a very good thing too. But I want to just, I want to get myself across to Pierre's before I get too involved in doing my farming and he sort of shuts his shop. And then we'll like have to wait until the morning, which would be the next episode. How bad would that be? Okay. An extra red mushroom for Marnie? Yeah, I have loads of them. Because I keep everything, because I'm a massive hoarder. Hi, Pierre. Parsnip seeds. Oh, that just reminds me of... Right, now. Community center. There is a certain... thing that we need for the community center. For the quality crop bundle, and yes, it is parsnips, so we do definitely need to plant parsnips this time. Then we need to plant melons in the summer, and that will be the end of the quality crops bundle. Once we've done that, it's just finishing off the artisan bundle and the animal bundle. We need to get the cows getting large milk and large goat's milk, or just getting some wool. Someone told me that you get wool off rabbits, but that seems really weird. They said that they were Angora rabbits. I don't know. There's a nice backpack there too, but I don't think... No, we need to focus on the task. So we'll buy 16 of those. Beans. Don't know. Cauliflowers, 8. 8 cauliflowers. Kale was quite good, I remember. So maybe a couple of fields of that. Garlic, that sounds good. I don't remember garlic from last year, so maybe that's a new one, because Pierre definitely said that he adds different things. Now then. Bears fruit in the spring. Cherry. Bears fruit in the spring. Bears fruit in the summer. Bears fruit in the summer. Bears fruit in the fall. So I could afford one of these. The pomegranate is definitely, definitely needed. But we've got until the end of spring to get the money together for that. So why don't we get... Well, why don't we just see if the community centre needs anything, firstly. So, that artisan bundle had a few things, like pomegranate, orange, and peach. So, either of those trees would be good. Apple is needed for a couple of things. It's needed for that sort of one on the bulletin board as well, if I remember rightly. So, I can have two of, like, any different fruit. Well, I can have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, I could actually finish that off just by planting fruit trees. Which I might even do. Okay, that's fine. So, we kind of need all of them. Did he have apple? He didn't, I don't think. Cherry, apricot, orange, peach, pomegranate. Oh, it does have apple. Okay, well, we'll definitely, like, on the very end of spring, beginning of summer, we'll go and get the pomegranate and the apple. Apricot is in the spring, and so is cherry, so we won't get those until spring of year 3 probably now, unless someone says that the greenhouse, you can plant things anytime you want, so we might be able to do that. But right now, the best thing to do is to plant trees for the summer. So I'm going to buy an orange sapling. So I have actually some money left to buy other seeds. I need a lot. I need, what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 plots worth, and I need 15 plots worth of stuff. So let's go back up here. We could get some beans. Don't see why not. We could get some jazz. Some flowers are always good for a little present for people. So we've got that. Cauliflower, potato, may as well. Tulip, may as well. Doesn't seem to be an awful lot of stuff, really. Some more garlic seeds, I guess. So, 2, 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Need two more. We'll do some more kale. I think that'll do for now. And they'll be done by my sprinklers and I will be very happy. Oh, Marnie, you're right there. I should have brought my mushroom to give to you as your thing. Your quest item. How long do I have to do that? 2 days. That's loads of time. Loads and loads of time. I'll probably forget now. Oh, look! How much money we spent and how much we had left. That was very well planned on my part, I think. But this will be the biggest harvest we've ever done so far. And it will probably give me the money I need to... No! I haven't done fertilizer! Thank goodness I only planted 2 things before I realized that. I'm an idiot because I've got so much sap from cutting all those trees down. Right, fertilizer, here we come. And I need about 120 fertilizer. I should be using shift for this. Right, that's 65. Do we have any more sap anywhere else? I thought so. None there. There's some gold in there though. Ooh, that's good. 197 there. Way too much of everything. Right, okay. Keep going with the fertilizer till I have about 60 more. 135, okay, that should be plenty to do all of these fields. Minus the 2 that I forgot. Because I'm a noob. What's nice about this is that we'll do this once. And then we won't really need to worry again for a little while, so we can go do other things with our time, which is really nice. And kale is kind of my cash crop for the spring, although there are much better cash crops, as we have discovered, like blueberries and cranberries, than we can get in the summer and the fall, or autumn as I like to call it. The cash crops definitely seem to be the cranberries and blueberries, whereas kale just seems to be okay, but not massively great. But just for starting us off at the beginning of the season, absolutely fine. Every time, dig up the sprinkler. And then you guys have to watch me scroll through the menu. Because I like to torture you. Okay. The therapeutic tilling of the land. Benefit from nature's bounty. too far forward there. There's just another few to go. You guys can place bets on how many sprinklers I will pull up doing this. You're all like, why didn't you upgrade your hoe? And I'm like, because it's only going to be like kind of a little bit of hoeing. Like one day's worth, and then it's all going to be over. So it's not like the watering can. And I don't intend to water anything ever again. Even if I waste days, I don't care anymore. I'm just like, I'm done with watering. I don't care if I have like, I don't know, an iridium watering can or something. I don't care. Sprinklers are the way forward. I've been waiting the whole game to get these. Oh god, we've spent like almost the whole day just doing these fields, but it's going to be so worth it. You just wait until these come to fruit. We are going to rake it in. And the best part about it, you guys don't have to watch me water the whole thing. One thing I'll probably do a bit later as well is go and just trim a bit of grass down so that the silo fills up again. Wait for the money to come in a little bit more and the copper bars and stuff, and then go see Robin and she can build us a silo. That was one thing I was kind of intending to do before the end of winter, but then I wanted to just make sure that I'd done, well, given it a chance to get a few more fish while it was still the winter season. I will probably use the fact that I've got some free time away from watering crops to go and do a little bit more fishing and mining. Get that all up to speed, and that'll be quite cool. Right, a couple of beds full of parsnips. I put it in the wrong place. No. Well, that means that field has to be for parsnips too then. Totally on purpose that was. That was in no way an accident whatsoever. So we've got some flowers now. They'll look good down here. Even the seeds look pretty on the flowers. I love those jazz seeds. They're so nice. All the other seeds are like brown and the jazz seeds are like, yeah, I'm blue. I'm rocking it. And then we'll have to work out where we want to put our orange tree. I want to be quite specific about that if I can. Oh no, that was possibly a really bad place to put those because there's a scarecrow right in the way. And I'm probably going to spend the whole of the spring season lamenting the fact that I chose to put the thing with the poles right by the scarecrow. Because that's how I roll. I do things, I think later. Garlic seeds from the last two, and that's us done with planting. Oh my goodness me. What a long time that took. Totally worth it though. Completely and utterly worth it. So we're gonna probably just have enough time to literally go in and see the chickens and the cows and say hi. And then that'll be it. So. Oh no, they're all asleep as well. They've all got food though, so. And they, oh, did every single one give me a large egg? Oh, that is nice. Good times. Good times, chickens. Sorry I can't say hi today. Won't you let me? Did I finally run out of hay in the silo? Did I literally run out on the last day? F- 5 pieces left. Wow. Yeah, well, we can always feed them again tomorrow. Because they've got enough left in their little stall. Get out the way! Oh! A new baby duckling hatched. Oh no, I haven't done comments in ages, so I don't know what to call it. I'm gonna call it Temmie. After Temmie Tem. So we have a duckling called Temmie. Hello, Temmie. She's like, I'm trying to sleep, go away. Why you come in here at like 9:30 at night, stupid human? Don't even know when it's nighttime. We'll add all these into the chest and then we'll try and decide which one we want to make mayonnaise out of. More mayonnaise makers will need to be a priority. And then I'll see if I can actually get some hay out of this one. Yeah, I can. I think the other one is maybe because there wasn't enough. There was as many ducks as there was already hay put out, so. But we'll have to cut some grass in the morning. Stuff in the way everywhere. Oh, mother catch. What's that for? Probably means I have caught like a certain amount of fish. Okay, so what I need to do before I go to bed is to have a look at where I want to put this orange tree. I'm kind of thinking that here might be a nice place for a few trees. I mean, we've already got a couple of trees here. Or we could go to the other side. But that's kind of where I wanted my slime thing. But this area, really, I hadn't sort of assigned it for anything much, really. So I think I will put the orange tree here. There. Orange tree. I might be able to, once I get some more oranges, I might be able to put them in the seed maker and then I'll be able to move it anyway. That'll be fine. But I just wanted to get it set off growing. That's the main thing. Oh, so much rubbish on my farm. I don't like this. It's been ages clearing it up. I might need to move that drum thing. It's kind of annoying. Why does that always happen? When it's like really late at night, I come in and they've taken a million days to do anything. But no, the minute I'm late to bed, the preserving bin's all finished. So typical. Anyway, so that was the first day of spring and that was all of the planting. So we're gonna go to bed now and see if anything cool happens. And then I will say goodbye for the day. Oh no, spreading weeds have caused damage to my farm. Okay, well, I guess we will find out exactly how much damage has been done. Fingers crossed that damage has not been done to my planting areas. Most of them were surrounded by bits of sort of road, so I'm hoping that they'll be okay. And that it will just have been maybe a few paths and things, or maybe a fence or two that's been affected by that. The chickens and cows weren't out anyway, so that should be okay. But anyway, that is the end of the episode for today. So thank you very much for joining me. If you liked the episode, then please leave me a like in the comment section below just to let me know that. And if you'd like to follow along a little bit further with the series, then if you subscribe, I can let you know when new videos are out. I hope to see you all next time. But in the meantime, look after yourselves and keep being awesome.